Hello everyone. Today we are going to learn what is meant by phasor diagram. Phasor diagram. Phasor diagram is a graphical or a pictorial representation of a phasor. It is known as a phasor diagram. What do you mean by phasor diagram? It is a graphical and or pictorial representation. So basically, phasor diagram is a pictorial representation of all phase voltages. It represents all phase voltages, their respective currents, and their respective current. Ekada all is considered in a network. Okay, the phasor is a rotating vector. It is a rotating vector. Okay, define vector. What is vector? Vector having the magnitude and direction. So basically, phasor is a rotating vector which having a magnitude and direction. So now let us consider, this is a plane. So first it is considered as omega 2 is equal to 0 degrees. So angular velocity is angular frequency is omega. Omega is equal to 0. So now second axis is treated as is equal to omega is equal to 90 degrees. It is omega t is equal to 180 degrees, which is omega t is equal to 270. This is also r. Omega t is equal to 360 degrees. Okay, so it is considered in anti-clockwise direction. If you consider in clockwise direction, it is minus 90, it is minus 180, it is minus 270. Similarly, it is also minus 360. So phasor is a rotating vector which rotate in anti-clockwise direction, which angular frequency is omega in the time domain. So now move on to, let us consider ZR means impedance is equal to R ohms. R means we can write as R angle of 0 degree. Rest in there is no angle. Okay. If I consider impedance of the inductance reactant ZL, Z omega L, which is measured in ohm. So this can be written as Z into XL ohms is equal to say an angle of 90 degrees. Okay, so instead of J I am replacing 90 degrees, where XL is equal to omega into L. Okay, next move on to capacitor reactions. Zc, impedance of the capacitance, which is measured in 1 by j omega c in ohms. So the z is transient in numerator, it will be treated as minus j into 1 by omega c. Okay, this can be rewritten as minus j into x c. So this can be rewritten as xc means capacitive reactance, an angle of minus 90 degrees, which is measured in ohm. Okay, where xc is equal to minus, sorry, 1 by omega c. This is capacitive reactance. Okay, move on to next slide. So up to now we dealt with how the phasor is rotated. Okay, how the their angle we are considered. So now move on to the conversion part, rectangle to polar form. Okay, so now we are discuss how to conversion from rectangle to polar. Okay, so we all studied in previous classes what is rectangle. Rectangle is either x coordinate or y coordinate or z coordinate. Polar means magnitude and direction with respect to reference. If I consider R, it is a theta. Okay, so rectangle conversion is all from the rectangle coordinates x, y, z. This is the z in third coordinate or 3D parameter. Okay. So now let us consider a simple RLC network having the resistance value 3 ohms and the inductance reactance value is XL is equal to 9 ohms. XC, capacitive reactance, is 5 ohms. So what is meant by the total impedance of the network, we will discuss in the previous classes. Z is equal to R plus J XL minus J omega C. So I am substituting corresponding values 3 plus J 9 minus J 5, which is simplified as 3 plus J 4. Okay, so what is the signal of Z? It is the rotating angle or rotation. Rotating angle, instead of representing 90 degrees, 180 degrees. Okay, and we are integrating with the Z operator. So Z is equal to 3 plus J 4. So what is the magnitude of the impedance? Z is equal to, we all learned complex variables, A plus IB. So what is the magnitude? Under root of square root of real part square plus imaginary part square. Similar way, mod Z is equal to 3 square plus 4 square. What is number 3 square, which is 9? What is number 4 square, which is 16? Okay, we will get 24. Root 25 is equal to 5, okay, which is measured in ohms. So in series circuit, we learned about impedance triangle. Okay, so I am considering base as a reference, which is resistive value 3 ohms. The total reactance of the inductance and capacitance consider pertinent to the resistance value, which is 4, and total impedance value, which is 5. Okay, so by using Pythagoras principle, we can write as cos phi is equal to 3 upon 5. How 3, how 5? Adjacent side upon hypothesis. Okay, so this is hypothesis, this is adjacent side, this is opposite side. Okay, so numerically we will get the value of cos phi is 0.6, which is measured in angle 53.1 degree. So I'm writing in polar form. Polar form. Z is equal to magnitude and angle. So phi an angle of 53.1 degree. Okay. Now let us consider one more example. Z is equal to R plus J XL minus J XC. So series combination of R L C parameter. So numerical values given as 6, XL is equal to 7, and XC is given 10. XC is given is 10. Okay, so substituting these values, 6 plus J 7 minus J 10. Okay, so 6 minus J 3 ohms. So magnitude, in order to find the magnitude, we are adding the square root of real parts and imaginary parts. 6 square plus 3 square. We will get 6 square is 36, 3 square is 9, so which is 45. Numerical value 6.7. Okay, so when the cos phi is equal to R by Z from the impedance triangle, what is the R value? 6 upon 6.7. We will get 26 upon 4 degrees, which is the phi value. It is phi value. Okay, so I'm writing polar form. Z is equal to Rm, phi is equal to, what is by R? 6.67. sorry, it is 6.7, and angle of 26.4 degrees Celsius. Okay. So conversion from polar to triangle. So till now we discussed how to conversion from rectangle to polar. Now we will discuss polar to rectangle form. Okay. So now I'm considering representation of the phase, so in magnitude and direction in the diagram. Draw it obstacles and ordinates. The obstacle represent a resistance value, and the ordinate represent the reactance value. Now I'm seeing the direction, mark the sign. If I consider, for example, 20 an angle of 120 degrees. it is given in polar form, and r and theta format. So what is in the r? It is 20. Okay, 20 into cos an angle phi r theta, it is equal to 20 an angle of cos 120. Okay, which is equal to 16.2836. So the value of x is equal to 20 into sine an angle of 120 degree. Okay, so 20 into sine 120 into 20. Which is 11.6122. Okay, please do not confuse how we get these values. Actually, please draw a inference triangle. This is Z, this is R, this is X. Total effect of the reactance of the inductance and capacitance. This is the resistance value, this is the impedance value. So now draw a angle. So from this we can write cos phi is equal to, or cos phi or cos theta, if consider phi an angle, cos phi is equal to adjacent side upon hypothesis. So from this we can write as r is equal to z into cos phi. So whatever the value is, total value, okay, z z means 20. Here it is, z is 20 and phi is 120 degree. Similar manner, sine phi is equal to opposite side. What is my opposite? X upon z. From this we can write as x is equal to z into sine phi. Just I am substituting, z value is 20 and phi value is 120. We will get these two values from the impedance triangle. Thank you.